I sat in my hammock, trapped in a war inside my own skin.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Akuma's Dojo, and for the first time, welcome to AD Cortex. I am Tyler Scales, your voice and commentator of the Akuma's Dojo, and tonight, for our first ever episode of Cortex, we have a total of 5 matches for you here tonight. Now, if you want to see the full match card, you can see our Twitter page at Akuma's_Dojo ETC. We have a total of 5 matches, and the first match tonight is going to be a hot one, as Rebecca Evans will be taking on our AD Women's Champion Jia Li in preparation for Glaucia Martins. Rebecca Evans made her debut in a triple threat, was not the victor, but with experience tonight, she is going to be Jia Li's opponent. Coming out of the ring now, it is your Akuma's Dojo Women's Champion, Jia Li. What a match for our first ever match for Cortex. This is a hell of an opener and a hell of a start. Now, Jia Li, she always loves to be in that ring and have a wrestling match. She grew up watching wrestling. She loves it very much. She's such a humble person, too, whenever you meet her backstage. Very, very nice person. Very humble. And she said a lot of great things about Rebecca Evans. When she heard about the match tonight, praised her for the long career she's had. But tonight, Jia Li, when that bell rings, you know she does not hesitate to kick your face in, because she does not hold back. She's a very different person when that bell rings. Jia Li in the dark pinkish color, and Rebecca Evans in that rustic purple attire. Referee rings the bell. Here we go. The inaugural show of Cortex begins. Jia Li bringing Rebecca Evans to the corner. Gonna give her some kicks. Rebecca Evans blocks it. Saw it coming. Gonna give her kicks of her own. Gonna go for a nice toss. Right hip toss right down to the mat. And look at that. Just taunting Jia Li. Slapping her in the head. Giving her a quick stomp to the arm. Jia Li responding with a jawbreaker. Missing that high kick though. Rebecca Evans saw that coming. Clearly Rebecca Evans put some time to study Jia Li and some of her movements. Jia Li though fighting back and a low kick. Gonna start going for some low kicks now. Rebecca Evans didn't see that coming. Oh, what a kick to the head. Very beautiful by Jia Li. I gotta start working on the ligaments here. Gonna start working on the legs. As Rebecca Evans could not counter those, she had trouble countering those low kicks. Now Jia Li picking her up here. And now she's going to start working on the chest here. And a big sucker ball kick right to the back. Not holding back with those kicks too is Jia Li. Now a huge drop kick. Now going for a pin here. Will this do it? 1, 2. No, very close though. Those kicks. As I said before, Jia Li does not hold back with the kicks she gives to her opponents. They're vicious. You'll be feeling them for weeks. Some more low kicks. And a nice hurricanrana. Rebecca Evans having some trouble here countering the champion now. Working on the arm now. Working on all parts of the body. But Rebecca Evans fighting back here. Club strike to the back. Dragging her to the middle of the ring now. I think she's going to go for a pin here. No, she took way too long to do something. And Jaya Lee responded. And going to the middle rope with the double axe handle right to the head. Now calling her to her feet. No, she had to go for that X Factor that helped her win the championship. Rebecca Evans is fighting back. Back and forth. But Rebecca Evans responding with the clothesline. Now picking her up here. Enziguri though. Nice counter by Jaya Lee. And once again, Rebecca Evans is stunned. Big kick there. Another big kick. And that high kick right to the face again. Going for the pin. One. Two. And that's going to do it. Jaya Lee with a very dominant performance. Lausia Martins, I hope she was watching this match. Those kicks, I'm telling you, they are vicious. Jaya Lee does not hold back with those. And once again, Jaya Lee, a very one-sided match. It's time to go to our next match in AD Cortex. Bad Company indeed has come forward for our next match. It's going to be Isaac Payne taking on Scott Ryan. Now Isaac Payne has been on the losing side of his matches recently. Hasn't been able to get a single win right after the Intercontinental Championship tournament. He was in the finale with Ryo Tazakazu. The winner would be the first ever Intercontinental Champion. Ryo Tazakazu won that match. And you know, speaking of Ryo, I really do wonder what's going through his head right now after the monstrous shit that Beginners did to IG. I don't want to think about that. It was just so messed up. That was just murder I watched on national television. I watched literal murder. And the fact that Beginners has a match tonight is crazy. He should not be here after what he did. Anyway, we'll focus on him later. But right now, Isaac Payne and Scott Ryan looking to climb through the rankings. Both men are on the losing side of matches. Coming out of the ring now is Scott Ryan, this Canadian psycho. Last time we saw him was in a fatal four-way to determine the number one contender for the Intercontinental Championship. He actually is the winner of the first ever steel cage match we've had here in the Akuma's Dojo. But last time we saw him, he was the runner-up in that match. An incredible counter by Beginners led to a pit of Hades, and Scott Ryan was down for the three count. Now Scott Ryan, he's a very tough opponent. He did eliminate someone in that matchup, that being the living sculpture, Silas Simeon. Even though Scott Ryan lost, he had a very impressive showing. And tonight, he looks to impress the fans even more in this match against Isaac Payne. Scott Ryan, this apocalyptic look. Jesus, man. He's really gone downhill in his life, has he? Isaac Payne wearing their usual trunks. The skull knee pads. Here we go. Referee rings the bell. Scott Ryan going to bring Isaac Payne to the corner here. Big knife that's chop. And now Isaac Payne got his legs hooked here. A very beautiful exploder suplex. Beautiful German as well. Isaac Payne now caught Scott Ryan in an inverted power slam. Very nice. Surely Scott Ryan didn't see that coming. Scott Ryan though, even though he's caught by surprise, gonna fight back. Big elbow right to the face. Now going to the top here. What's he got planned? A very beautiful top rope moonsault by Scott Ryan. And gonna immediately go for the pin. One, two. Close fall. cover, and the face up did not hook the legs. He already had him. Isaac Payne now with a nice dragon screw counter. Gonna work on the arms a little bit more here. Scott Ryan with another counter, quick kick to the head. And going for a springboard DDT, going off the middle rope, but Isaac Payne immediately recovering, taking him down. The nice STO, immediately picking him up here. Gonna carry him to the corner. And look at these uppercuts he's gonna be giving to Scott Ryan, these European uppercuts. Every single one landed, every single one of them hurting. Another European uppercut, a running European uppercut at that. Off to the other corner, another European uppercut. And now off the ropes, a beautiful drop kick. All the momentum in Isaac Payne's favor. He might have won the match right there. One, two. Oh, a close fall. All those vicious uppercuts did not put away Scott Ryan, though. Picking him up now. What's he going for here? Oh, man! An F5-like maneuver from Isaac Payne, similar to the Pit of Hades. Very nice. He's not done there. Got the arm hooked. But Scott Ryan recovering and now fighting back with some vicious body blows. And what is this? What a standing Uranagi! Immediately picking up Isaac Payne. Now going to go for looking for a suplex. No, he's not. Bam! The final end. That might do it. Going for the pin. One, two. No! A kick out by Isaac Payne. The final end by Scott Ryan. Picking up Isaac Payne here. Going to go for something, but did not matter. Isaac Payne going for a middle rope moonsault. Scott Ryan with the moonsault of his own. Anything you can do, I can do better. And now, going to slow it down a little bit here. Going to work on the ligaments. No, he's not. Never mind. Going for a top rope moonsault. Very nice by Scott Ryan. Now got him in a camel clutch submission. Looking to tap him out or make him pass out. Isaac Payne not giving up, though. He's still got some life in him. Looks like he's passing out. But he's still got life. Scott Ryan picking him up now. What the hell is this? Oh my god, what a move by Scott Ryan in a fireman's carry position. And picking up Isaac Payne once again. Off the ropes. Oh man, just an elbow right to the face. Isaac Payne looks stunned here, but no he's not. He missed the clothesline, but man, both men are going back and forth. Elbows blocked. And wait a minute, got him picking up again. Oh my god, that F5-like maneuver again. Referee taking a long time to go for the pin. At a two here, no, another close fall. Isaac Payne cannot believe it. And once again, calling Scott Ryan to his feet, looking to finish the match. Picking him up. A suplex pile driver. That's got to do it. No way he's getting out of that. One, two. You got to be kidding me. He kicked out? How the hell he kicked out of that? If I were Scott Ryan, there is no way I'm kicking out of that. That is a hell of a move. And another exploder suplex. We'll go for a middle rope moonsault. Did not connect. Picking him up here. Revolution knee by Scott Ryan. That's got to do it. No, he's not done there. Oh, a headbutt. Holy shit. Another moonsault from the top rope. That's got to do it. There's no way he's in this. At a two. You got to be kidding me. Both of these men have been putting on one hell of a match. Wait a minute. Scott Ryan calling Isaac Payne once again. Final end. Well, that for sure do it. One, two, and that will do it. What a match by both men. Holy shit, what a match. Boy, the next three matches in here, not sure they're gonna be topping that. Both men gave it their all tonight, but Scott Ryan picking up the win. Picking up some serious momentum here as well. Looking forward to seeing more of Scott Ryan after that match. But now, it is time for our next matchup. We still got one hell of a show packed here tonight. We still got three more matches, but up next is Nora North taking on Amber Blackwell. And right now, Nora North's making her way to the ring. Tonight, she has a hell of a challenge here. A new Amber Blackwell, as we saw in episode 11. She said she's tired of being someone that follows a script. She wants to be herself now, and she clearly has a new look on her. And so does Nora North. I'm looking forward to seeing what Nora North will do tonight. She's definitely keeping her cool, it seems, after everything that Amber Blackwell said. I'm not going to repeat whatever Amber Blackwell said. That was all very inappropriate. I'm surprised that got aired on, but, well, you got aired on. But now Nora North awaits Amber Blackwell, the queen of Suffolk County. Wow, just seeing Amber Blackwell up close now. She is a completely new woman, completely new attitude, new personality. We don't know who this woman really is. I'm looking forward to seeing what she has to offer. I'm not going to lie to you. I don't appreciate what she did to Veronica Griffin on episode 10, but... Excuse me, episode 9, but... I got to be honest, I am excited to see the new Amber Blackwell. I wonder what she's going to do tonight. She definitely will not be holding back. That's one thing for sure. And she said in the last episode, in episode 11, that she wants to break Nora North's arm. Is she going to do it tonight? Well, we'll find out. Amber Blackwell does not seem to be a woman who holds back anymore. She wants to be a completely her own woman. She has definitely stated that. A new look, a new everything. I can't wait for it. Well, I'm taking up their entrance attires now. Nora North in the light blue. Amber Blackwell in the black. No longer wearing the green. Referee rings the bell. Here we go. Nora North. Got it. Amber Blackwell in a fireman's carry here. Gonna start off with the snake eyes in the corner. No. Nora North off the ropes. What a knee, my god. Jeez, Amber Blackwell definitely feeling that one. And a springboard 450 splash. Nora North trying to start off hot, but Amber Blackwell moved out of the way. Gonna start doing some damage on the arm. Amber Blackwell's finisher, a disarmer. Trying to make Nora North tap out immediately. Standing German suplex. Very nice. And, oh, come on with that. Just scrubbing her face on the mat and an elbow drop right to the back. Amber Blackwell already playing dirty tonight. Nora North fighting back here. Putting her on the ropes. And oh, Nora North clearly did not like that. Slapping her in the face a little bit. Got her trapped on the ropes. Oh, man, nice drop kick. Amber Blackwell back on her feet. She got plans here. Nice fisherman suplex. Bridging into a pin as well. Athleticism of Amber Blackwell being shown here tonight. Off the ropes now. Nice leg drop. And going for another one, but no. And Nora North saw that one coming, moving out of the way. And look at this. Handspring Pele kick. Very nice by Nora North now off the ropes. Oh, what a knee drop. And now Nora North calling Amber Blackwell to her feet. Trying to go for a drop kick, but Amber Blackwell moved out of the way. But Nora North quick to respond after missing the drop kick. Amber Blackwell fighting back now, slapping her in the face. And Nora North does not appreciate that. Picking her up. What is this? Got her in a crucifix here. A crucifix sitting powerbomb. Very nice by Nora North. Nora North, incredible plethora of moves. I got the arms hooked here. What the hell is this? Underhook pile driver is what that move was just now. Going for the pin. One, two, no. I bet you Amber Blackwell does not want to lose this match. She hasn't won her match in Akuma's Dojo yet. She's had yet to have a win. Oh my god, holy shit, what a shooting star press from the top. One, two. Oh, again, Amber Blackwell kicked out. As I was saying, Amber Blackwell yet to have a win in this, in the Akuma's Dojo. She does not want to clip another loss. Now, what is this? Amber, it's Nora Knowles with an incredible counter, but Amber Blackwell gonna have a nice counter of her own. The skill of both women being shown here right now as they're going back and forth. Amber Blackwell now with another counter. What is this? Oh man, she's gonna throw her back right into the corner, her lower back. Gonna be in a lot of pain here. Working on the arm once again, very smart by Amber Blackwell. Picking her up now. Wait a minute, she's going for the disarmer here. She's got it hooked. She's got it hooked in tight. Will Amber Blackwell tap Nora North out here? Nora North can't seem to get out of this. And Nora North has to tap. Amber Blackwell getting her first win here tonight in the Akumu's Dojo. The Queen of Suffolk County is victorious on Cortex. A really good match. Very exciting finish. Both women were going back and forth. Now Amber Blackwell finally getting her first win tonight. I wonder if someone like Ronda Griffin will be watching, seeing the new Amber Blackwell. Very good match. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we are halfway through the show of Akuma's Dojo Cortex, our first inaugural episode, and right now, it's going to be Ed Storm's Open Challenge. Now, Ed Storm, we saw him episode 9 take on Jason Wolfe. Was short and a very good match. And now Jason Wolfe's going to be facing for the World Championship as Malcolm Quinn. That's going to be exciting. Ed Storm was a good preparation for him, but Ed Storm was not happy about the loss. He said to me that Jason Wolfe was lucky when he beat him. But clearly, Ed Storm is salty about that loss against Jason Wolfe. I mean, listen, Jason Wolfe's a tough opponent, man. It happens. We all lose. But Ed Storm did not want to take that lightly. And tonight, he has challenged the locker room for an open challenge. Let's see if Ed Storm is prepared for this opponent. And let's see who's going to answer. Oh, boy. You know damn well I'm excited for this. It's the smallest bruiser, Leo McKay. This guy, boy, let me tell you. He is one of the most exciting wrestlers to watch. One of the most technical wrestlers we've seen here in the professional wrestling world. And tonight, he is answering Ed Storm's challenge. Ed Storm, man, I hope you're ready, because this guy is going to whoop your ass for sure. He is not hold back for his attacks. His moves are vicious. This guy is a no-nonsense wrestler. This is Leo McKay. Last time we saw Leo McKay, he took on his old rival, his old friend, Jacob Hero. And he beat him. He beat him pretty clean. And tonight, Leo McKay is back to answer this open challenge. And boy, the fans are happy to see him back. Doesn't feel the same way, but listen, Leo McKay is for sure a future champion. I am very excited to see what he will bring to the table tonight. Just walking around the ring, letting the fans know that this is where he dominates. This is where he stays. They win. Now both men are in the ring. Leo McKay just staring him down. And here we go. Leo McKay in action. Let's do this. Leo McKay going to start some quick strikes here. Some vicious elbows. Now, I'm going to give a quick little summary about Leo McKay. As he just gives an absolute Shibata-style headbutt to Ed Storm. Leo McKay began his career in SWF down in Texas in the Southern Wrestling Federation that was built by CM Puma. So he started off pretty hot. He's a former champion too, having held a title before, a tag team title. After the SWF had ended, he entered the RSD Tag Team Tournament alongside with Jacob Hero, where those two formed an unlikely alliance. And they did pretty well in that tournament, having some wars in that tournament. And Leo McKay had a hell of a showing as he got signed to FPW and made a appearance at their biggest pay-per-view, Starlight. So this guy clearly has some notable success. But tonight he's back here in the Akuma's Dojo, looking to gain another victory as both men putting their arms up while waiting to strike. But Leo McKay, oh my god, just absolutely knocked Ed Storm off his boots. Now throwing him to the corner. And now, Ed Storm is trapped in a trio position here. and he's just going to rub his boot all over his face. Leo McKay will fight dirty. And he looks to end this right now as he gets him in a military press at Storm. Incredible counter. No. Tried to steal a victory there, but Leo McKay kicked out at one. Now Ed Storm, he's no slouch either, let me tell you. Ed Storm is no slouch in that ring. And look at this. Rolling into that move. That was beautiful. And looks to end it here, calling Leo McKay to his feet. Wants to end this quickly. Wants to spoil the surprise of Leo McKay by beating him here. Oh, he hits his finisher. Rolling Storm. But unfortunately, Leo McKay Storm did not pay attention to his surroundings, resulting in a rope break. Gonna go for a kitchen sink knee, but Leo McKay moving out of the way. Both men fighting back now. Nice German suplex by Ed Storm. A monkey flip by Leo McKay. Very nice. The technical skill of Leo McKay being shown once again. And wait a minute. No. Ed Storm with a nice counter. Looked like he was going for his finish and rolling the dice. But Ed Storm read that one very clean. And now Ed Storm, not having a lot of momentum right now. Big kick to the back by Leo McKay, going to the top rope. Oh my god, a double foot stomp all the way from the top. That actually might do it. He might have crushed his ribs. One, two, no. A close fall there. Ed Storm kicking out immediate, right at the last second. Now Leo McKay calling him to his feet once again. Got him another military press here. And a military press gutbuster, his signature, immediately picking him up, not wasting any time. Gonna go for the roll of the dice. And he hits it. Will that do it? One, two, and three. Leo McKay not holding back and getting the victory at Storm. And wanted an open challenge. Challenged anybody to the locker room. He failed. And Leo McKay getting another win here in the Akuma's Dojo. A very good match. And Leo McKay, ladies and gentlemen, he is back in the Akuma's Dojo. And he, you know damn well, Leo McKay wants some gold. Leo McKay, he is not someone to play around with. This guy is tough. But now, it is time to go to our main event. Beginnis will be taking on Rayanis Lagari. Let's see if Beginnis is prepared to get another win. It is time for our main event. And coming down the ring now, it is Rayanis Lagari. And there he is, Rayanis Lagari. He has buffed up the last time we saw him, clearly in this hiatus. He has gained a lot of weight in the best way possible. This guy is now bulked up. He's gone to the gym, lifted those weights. And tonight, he's going to be taking on Beginnis. Now, last time we saw Rayanis Lagari, he took on Malcolm Quinn on the first episode that yours truly made his debut on commentary in the main event. And Rayanis Lagari did an amazing job facing Malcolm Quinn, but he could not gain the victory. He was close, but couldn't get the victory. And tonight he hopes to gain his first victory against Beginnis here tonight. And boy, I hope Rayanis is ready. I hope he saw what he did to Aiji Megumi. And you know what, Rayanis? I wish you luck, man. I hope you beat him. I really do. The lights have gone dark. All you see now is nothing but pure gold. Here comes Beginnis, looking to honor the 12 great Olympians in this match and prepare for Ryo Tazakazu for his Akuma's Dojo Intercontinental Championship match upcoming. Now, Beginnis, this man loves violence. He does it to honor gods like Ares, like Hades. And he clearly showed that in episode 11 when he brutalized Aiji Megumi. Literally murdered that man on national television. I'm telling you again, that was straight murder. This man is a monster for what he did. I cannot condone what he did on episode 11. I don't think he understands how horrific that truly was. This man only has one thing on his mind, and that is to absolutely destroy, dismantle his opponents, who was thought to be an honorable Greek warrior, turns out to be a psycho who wants to honor gods that aren't really around anymore. But let's see if Beginnis be able to get this win against Rihannis Lagari as he prepares Ryo Tazekazu. Rihannis is a tough opponent. Now the lights have turned back on. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your main event. Rihannis Lagari, Beginnis. The referee rings the bell, here we go. I hope that everyone has been enjoying this new setup here with the AD Cortex. This is a new show that is meant to build talent here that don't get a chance to really showcase themselves on the actual episodes of Akuma's Dojo. This is meant to build that talent up, climb the rankings, and hopefully get a chance at some championship gold. Let's get to the match here. Beginnis. Right now, he's hoping to get another win here. He's currently undefeated in the Akuma's Dojo. But I have to be honest. What he did, I lost so much respect for him. That was not condoned. That didn't need to be happen, and it did. It just, I don't like to think about it. But let's just get to the match here. Let's focus on what's been happening. So far, Beginnis has been throwing Rihannis right around. He's been throwing him with suplexes, slams, and just these clubbing blows. My God, Rihannis has no response to them so far. He has just been getting absolutely just destroyed here. He's been getting dismantled piece by piece. This is exactly what Beginnis wants. And look, Beginnis, he does look ready for the championship match. Even though I think he should be banned from action, just at least suspended for what he did. He's here right now, and he has been putting on one hell of a show. But Rihannis, he's been fighting back now, got him on the ropes. Just doing the best he can to stun this big man here. Oh, what a stomp to the arm. Almost dismantled a little bit there. Rihannis right now just giving some stumps in the arm. Last time we saw Rihannis, a little bit more skinnier, but now he's bulked up clearly in the heavyweight division now. And a nice sweep of the legs. Looking to get some momentum back in his favor as Beginnis has been dominating most of this match. Oh, but what a knee to the stomach. And a powerbomb too, my God. Going for the pin here, 1, 2, and that's it? Wow, that was a very one-sided match. Rihannis barely even did anything to this man. Very dominant win by Beginnis. Clearly Rihannis was out of his... Holy shit! Ryo has thrown out a huge challenge on episode 12! What will we begin to say? Well, ladies and gentlemen, we now have a title night on episode 12. I hope you look forward to it.